Do I have to hit enter?
I can do it.
All right. Cool. So one of the things that I'm really interested in is how to tap into the human desire to learn and create. It's a constant challenge to find ways of stimulating student-initiated learning experiences and to break them of bad habits created by our education system. This project that I'm going to talk about is an answer to some of these questions, and it finds its energy in the beauty of mark-making as a response to our intuitions. This is something most young children understand, but gets lost. This is the very first project that I engage my foundation students in. Day one is introductions, and day two, we begin experiences. Important things to know is that we break down the classroom walls by working outside the classroom and taking over hallways in the school. We bring every medium that students might use over the course of the year to make connections to future project processes. We are working directly on a wall, not at a desk. This is about being active, freed from the confines of a desk, and having the room to move around with the context of primitive wall marking. Coming up is a video that I show my students on day two. It illustrates the process and disposition that I'm interested in creating. Giving and taking away, art is an action which requires energy, and that energy needs to be transferred into the work. Fear of making mistakes and of creativity must end. This is about jumping in, making marks, and responding. Let the work tell you what to do. There's no creation without motion. Enjoy the process, learn from, and build confidence. Don't overthink things, and don't be afraid to cover up areas. Layering is a huge target of this process. Drawing is the arrangement of line and mark within space and has a variety of purposes. So we're in a hallway, and I tell you to stand 2 feet away and get ready. You walk up to your work, you lean into it, and you make a motion across your page, kind of like a Tai Chi motion. Maybe it's defensive, maybe it's aggressive. Now get the heck out of there, stand back, look at your work, and take it in for no more than 10 seconds. Now jump at it again, but this time reacting to your last movements. Keep it abstract, keep it expressive, and let it flow through you. Drawing is a powerful language capable of expressing things not easily conveyed in any other way. Sometimes people draw something to be descriptive, like when they draw people or objects. This is what most people think of when mentioning drawing, but it can also be the most intimidating. Drawing is expressive. It can communicate things that are intangible or invisible, such as your memories, ideas, and emotions. The best news is that anyone can draw like this, and it can serve as the building block to other leaps in art. Now stand back, look at what you're doing, and take part in a dance of going back and forth. Grab a piece of charcoal. This will make darker and more prominent marks. What do you like about your lines? What don't you like? Now obliterate. Grab your wide brush and cover your art with gesso. At least one third of it. Look for areas that make you feel good and embrace them. Keep them for now. Obliterate what you don't like. Do this for 30 seconds. Push your marks back into the space. It was something you did, is now part of your past. This is about teaching layering. Notice how the white paint interacts with the other mediums to make new marks through destruction. Now, look at your piece and assert. Pick out a drawing tool and add to your paper again. You can go back over the dark areas or parts that you obliterated. The choice is yours. Respond to your marks. This white paper is a stage, a world in which you are filling it with energy and expression. This process of asserting and obliterating is repeated over and over. Teach process and dispositions that will carry through the year. This is their very first experience with art in my school, and they commit to a learning process that will enrich their experiences. Students must give themselves to it, open up to the mark making, and embrace self-guided journey. A large part of this process is walking around and discussing each student's work with them. The students do this with each other, with students walking by in the hallway, and we start to form a voice in the work together. The students tell me stories that are being told in the work. I never had to instruct them to find a story. They just do it naturally. This project really touches on a human desire to create, feel, and communicate without words. I'm always impressed with the quality of work, especially among the less talented draftsmen. But again, this is the first project, so I don't know that yet. After a week or so, we take a break and go back into the classroom to connect their experiences to famous artists that came before them. It is important that it's done after they begin their work. Work and experience first. Now we learn from that experience and connect to existing media. Here we discuss composition, the principles of design, color and line. We look at many abstract expressionists, including Basquiat and Mondrian, as seen here. We talk about the different approaches and compositional elements that that they bring to the work together. Students seek out artists who seem to have a similar style and voice to the work they've already created. They can take these connections back with them to the hallway. Many students print out imagery to help them emulate a desired approach. Others choose to keep it fresh and from their own minds as much as possible. both paths are embraced as I begin to facilitate student finding their own ways of learning. It is helpful to provide as many avenues for students to take as possible, but they must choose that desired approach on their own. From here, when the students are finalizing their visions, as I said, much of this work connects to future projects and progression of curriculum. We follow into drawing from observation after students gain confidence here. We start to use all the mediums they experience in this project, moving from practice into finalizing work. This eventually flows into other ideas of public art, of street art, of engaging civic engagement. I give more and more control to the students with an emphasis on critique and self-assessment as the semester moves, and I empower them to be aware of their environment, promote communication, and teach them how to individually, collectively affect the environment around. Working on the walls and in the halls is a form of advocacy in itself, which is always an overarching theme in the work we do. In the hallways, students and teachers walk by as our class participates in a fun and vibrant exercise of reflection, mark making, and design. Here, a dialogue is born which connects the art class to everyone outside of it. This starts to promotion of public art, which grows throughout the year. When completed, we use painter's tape to frame the displays the students work on in untraditional places outside of showcases, directly on a wall. I hang informative signs with the work, explaining and supporting the many desired outcomes of the project, which also seeks to educate students who are not a part of the experience. The result is that the project starts a dialogue with the school administration, the student body, celebrates and educates on the artistic process, and drives enrollment. It beautifies a boring hallway, and among other class targets, builds a sense of public communication and protest through art, a theme that grows into future projects. There's a commitment established here that is extraordinary with this project. The student on the left painted 3 finished works under this final piece, all wonderfully crafted, but she kept going over it again. The students work obsessively, and I carry this into the theme of creative activism in the future, which is using the arts to create awareness of important issues around the world and to inspire positive change. The process is one part, and they learn it well here, but being an active agent of change is the true curriculum. I want students to use their creativity to innovate the world. Thank you.